I don't deal with crazy. I don't know crazy. I ain't worried about it, alright?
Good to know. But the question is, exactly who's more, quote-unquote, crazy? Alexandra Mayers, me, I'm taking Mrz Parker's excellent advice to move on from Good Times for Life. Perhaps Good Times for Life should take the same advice and move on from me, Alexandra Mayers, considering he feels he's being harassed, stalked, and now is entertaining getting lawyers involved, not too unlike how RIP Royce felt in regards to his independent investigative coverage of her and the crush that he developed upon her.
Alexandra just posted a video.
What are you talking about?
Yeah.
I need cigarettes. What?
Dude?
Somebody posted a video about what?
You.
About me. Oh, that's a big shocker because she's obsessed with me.
Okay.
It's holy shit.
Video titled "The Double Talk of Good Times for Life Claims of Harassment to Chicken Cakes, Mrz Parker Was Correct." Okay, come on.
You know that's crazy. I'm not even going to watch it.
Of course it is.
I'm not even going to watch it. I don't want to talk about it.
You want me to read the description?
Yeah, read the description. I'm not watching the video, though.
No. The above video clip from the actor who plays Good Times for Life's live stream with Chicken Cakes about Alexandra Mayers illustrates his double talk and hypocrisy in regards to the claims of Alexandra harassing him. In the video, he states, "Is love to see a podcast featuring a panel consisting of Chicken Cakes, Alexandra Mayers, and Amber HHH, a public figure, criminal, and woman known to aggressively seek negative attention harassment when criticized for a questionable style of parenting."
So who is the criminal? Who'd she say was a criminal? Amber is a criminal. That's what she said.
How do you scam credit cards, Amber? What's the best way?
How about yourself? What's the best way to scam credit cards?
Right? You know all the...
Oh.
Yeah, you can go if you want to, too. I'm not going to fucking put up with it. I mean, you can stay, but I'm not going to put up with that no more.
It's funny what you're saying, you know?
It's like, not funny to me because I have people already going around calling me a scammer and shit because of that right there.
Well, I mean, yeah, whatever.
What?
You should let him back on, though.
He can suck my dick when he says sorry, maybe. I'm not fucking putting up with it no more now. He already got me in a bad fucking mood. And you guys all fucking say I'm the fucking drama and I'm the problem. I was just chilling. Trying to have a good fucking time.
He was just being funny, saying you were out looking for dates and stuff. He was just being funny, like, you know.
No, he just said, "How do I scam credit cards then?"
He was just being funny.
He's talking about my felony that I've talked about a million fucking times about taking my fiance's card and not fucking telling him. But he wants to keep randomly bringing it up. Like, what the fuck? I'm done with him.
Yeah, your fiance brought charges against you for that?
No, he didn't. He didn't know it was me. And it was like fucking 3 or 4 years ago when I did it. And I didn't fess up to it until after he had already fucking reported it to the bank and shit. And so the fucking bank and the state, this bank and the state pressed charges. He did not. He wasn't gonna.
Yeah, the state takes over the charges usually in most places.
Exactly, especially when the person doesn't want to.
If it's a felony, for sure. If it's a state charge, yeah.
Alexandra Mayers was open to speaking publicly because I did say she said she was open to it. Alexandra Mayers was open to speaking publicly on a podcast with Chicken Cakes, aka Simply Cupcake, prior to her interview with Mrz Parker. I didn't have an interview with Mrz Parker,
right?
But since receiving excellent insight and advice from Mrz Parker, Alexandra has decided to move on from all issues and individuals linked directly to the actor known as Good Times for Life.
Well, that's awesome. That's awesome. She's moving on, right?
That's good. It is not healthy to want to see someone who claim you want nothing to do with a podcast or communicate with your friends. In fact, it's abusive to yourself, your friends, and the person you claim to want out of your life. I guess that's you.
We talk very little about the situation. Very little.
We tried not to say, you know, very little. Mm. So, but whatever that video is unnecessary.
You know what? You know what I could do to piss her off even more? I could keep on having you and Amber come on here and just talk to you guys for hours and hours and hours.
Oh,
and,
yeah. So well, because she thinks that
I'll fry her brain.
I'm not trying to block her from you. I just know you as my friend that you don't want anything to do with her.
I want to be single. Listen, I want to be single. I don't want anything to do with any woman, all right? I want to be single, all right? You know what? I wish it wasn't Alexandra Mayers that was obsessed with me and it was fucking RIP Royce. But you know what? There's only so many things you can wish for in life. Apparently, I did not get my wish. So I gave my wish, I got the opposite of it. I got the opposite of my wish. Holy hell. It's funny. Come on, man. You guys have to laugh a little bit. You can laugh with me. Holy fuck. What the fuck? Come on, man. Come on. You guys gotta find the humor in it. You guys gotta find the fucking humor. Right? Give what you wish for. Yes. No, Royce has a boyfriend. She's very happily now in a relationship with a boyfriend, and I think he's rich. That's why she quit streaming. So, all the more power to her, dude. All the more power to her. You know, I'm happy for that. I'm actually happy she found a guy with a lot of money. To me, that fucking is amazing. It's actually amazing.
Today, on the previous video over here on the IP2 Wiki News YouTube channel, someone known as Barb Sawyer left the comment that Mrz Parker is a rock star. I, Alexandra Mayers, completely agree. I actually responded that she's of goddess level. I agree. Unfortunately, I was just informed that though I'm moving on, Good Times for Life is going to continue discussion of me, just to quote-unquote piss me off. Though allegedly I'm the one stalking and harassing him, which is all quite telling. My main concern, though I'm moving on from the issue, is that since my respectful departure from Good Times for Life podcast and life, due to his extensive need for interaction and attention, Chicken Cakes is essentially being forced to fill the void I left in his life, which takes a substantial amount of time away from her child and husband. I hope one day the actor who plays Good Times for Life finds someone to give him the amount of time, attention, and entertainment that I once did. I also hope that that person has the right skin color and is of the right race, a race at least that he's comfortable with being around.
What's up? How's it going?
Well, you lured me in with Black Betty, but it's already over.
What the song only lasts like what, 3 minutes?
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
It's one of my faves.
Black Betty. Yeah. Wham blam.
Wham blam, whoa, Black Betty. Wham blam. She really beats me. Wham blam.
You know what that song is about, right? It's about a white dude that fucked a black woman.
Okay, well, I didn't need to know that, but I still like the song.
You guys know any lawyers? I did know some lawyers. I have friends that are lawyers, but I don't want this to keep going on. This is fucking retarded. This is really fucking retarded. right. I am over this shit. I'm so fucking far over this shit. So I'm fucking. I've been in contact with some people that fucking. I'm so fucking done with this crack. This crack. Crack is whack. And fucking shit is going on. It's fucking crack, right? I'm fucking done. I'm done. I'm over with it. It is fucking annoying. It's literally fucking annoying. And, shit gets old. Shit gets old real fast, okay? Shit gets really fucking old real fast. I have some friends that are lawyers. I'm gonna have to fucking send more messages and, see what they can tell me about the situation.
Oh, but, I told you, like, everything cool that I've watched.
Oh.
And there, you know, the only other thing is I don't want to talk about. We don't want to talk about diseases. We've covered, like, diseases. We've covered movies, actors, cinematography, what was watched lately, those who not shall be named, barely. What else can we talk about?
No, you're here. You have something to talk about.
I'm here because you asked me to come back when you got cigarettes. So,
right.
You came back. And you were playing Black Betty. And I love you, so.
You like Black Betty, that's cool.
Yeah. Only from the memories it holds for me. Not like I don't need to know the meaning of it, but the memories it holds for me. I love it.
You know, I was only born in 1969, so all the shit is like way before my time, right? You know that?
Right. You were born in 1969.
79.
I'm like, duh.
Well, I've already been doxed, so everybody knows my birth certificate.
I know. I'm 4 years older than you, so we're the same age. We would have been in high school or at the same time.
High school? When I was in high school, people were listening to Nirvana and shit.
Me too, but I was a senior.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah. So do you have anything to talk about?
To be honest, no. I just came to say hi because you went to leave and you said, will you come back? I said, I come back, you're playing Black Betty, I came back. Yeah. I don't know. I talked for three hours already.
It's fine, but you don't have anything to talk about whatsoever.
I don't. We've talked about so much this morning.
So,
Lou Pearlman, Weinstein's. I don't know what the hell is even left on the table.
You talk about how you went outside and saw a butterfly today or something.
But I didn't go outside. I went out to the living room and found my 10-year-old or 11-year-old sleeping on the couch. I thought that was weird.
Why is somebody sleeping on a couch weird?
Because he's 11 and usually he's screaming like an animal in his room right now, playing games.
He was sleeping on the couch.
Now he's sleeping on the couch.
Nothing wrong with sleeping on the couch, right? Jason wants sugar cakes to analyze the RV trips.
Oh, God. Analyze them.
How is your husband fucking understanding you, like, fucking getting fucking random messages just nonstop all day long?
I don't get random.
If you're my bitch, I'd be like, fucking stop talking to these fucking fuckers on the internet.
Oh, yes. Well, he does say that. But after all this time now, he kind of gets why. Mm-hmm. I'm a social person, and I, you know, that's all. He understands it a lot more.
If you don't stop talking to these fucking idiots on the internet, it's going to ruin your marriage, all right?
No, we're good.
It's not good.
Are you married?
I know how it works. You guys are not good, all right?
It's okay.
It's not okay.
It wasn't. Look, okay. So sometimes it's not okay. And one of those not okay times happened to be last night. And you see, I didn't make it to any podcasts I was supposed to. So that, yes, he's accepting of it, but he doesn't like it taking all of my time
away. I'm going to piss you off really bad right now.
No, probably not.
If I was married and I had a child, I would not be here.
To the actor who plays Good Times for Life, I, Alexandra Mayers, sincerely hope that a white woman who's of a quote-unquote race you feel comfortable with enters your life. I truly do. In the meantime, leave me alone, as it's evident you want nothing to do with me and my appearance that you've made blatantly clear disgusts you. Any lawyer or attorney will say to you exactly what I outlined in this video. Perhaps consider talking to Mrz Parker, because it's quite possible that you need to hear from someone like her what I tried very kindly to tell you for over a year.